डॉक्टर आरिफ अलवी इस्लामाबाद में तकरीब से खिताब कर रहे हैं, आइए आपको लिए चलते हैं।
Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, assalamu alaikum. It gives me immense pleasure to be here to participate in the launching ceremony of the study of the diaspora philanthropy in the UK, and I congratulate the Pakistan Centre of Philanthropy for a number of things and the British Council, and thank the sponsors for a number of things, particularly for being able to recognize those institutions whose accounts are good and who can be presented as trustworthy to the people, because that's what I heard in part of that presentation, that the trustworthiness is an important factor. And those of us in Pakistan know for that fact that the people did not want to pay taxes because they did not trust the government, but they did trust ED Foundation, the Shaukat Khanam, the TCF, the Indus Hospital, and you name it. And the people do trust those areas, and therefore they put in a lot of money into that kind of philanthropy. It supports the government's agenda as we look towards a welfare state which is responsible for the poor, for elevating people out of poverty, for establishing the basic needs of health and of education. And I'm very, very proud of the fact that we see that the diaspora is taking good part. There's, for the first time, or in the past few years, maybe a few times before, some numbers have been put on to what we have been believing for a long time. I believe very strongly that Pakistanis, related to their GDP, they may be in quantum, we may not be as big, but related to our GDP and per capita income, Pakistan stands is outstanding as far as philanthropy is concerned. And I have a personal feeling, and these things are anecdotal until you establish a study and you establish real facts and figures, but these things are anecdotal, and I always relate those things. For example, I was in Chicago at the time of the New Orleans disaster, and I was in Pakistan at the time of the earthquake in 2005, and I was very, very impressed by the fact that an average Pakistani, the way he reacted, and an average US citizen, the way he reacted. And there is a background to that. In established democracies, in wealthy countries, it is expected that the government should take care. And therefore, I found a general belief in the US society that the government must be taking care. But as far as the people were concerned in New Orleans, I saw some looting, some plunder, etc., going on at the same time. While in Pakistan, when I saw that in Pakistan, you remember that there were hundreds of thousands of cars which moved towards the earthquake area. People from Karachi put up everything which they could collect into their cars, and they went on volunteering their effort, volunteering their money, and towards charity. It's a very strange belief which I have. I believe that Pakistan, because of its ethos, The giving factor in Pakistan has kept, despite the fact that there has been plundering of society. I would not like to go into politics of that. Despite that, people rose, people built institutions, people built charitable hospitals and educational institutions, and did a tremendous amount of charity. And these are all my heroes. So the awards I give today, I really admire you people, so keep that in mind. It's an appreciation. It's an appreciation which comes from my heart. And what they have done is they have filled the gap with the government. They have not been able to yet, they will not be able to, because the government, if the government leaves gaps, it is very difficult to fill. And in the 90s, I made a few decisions in life. One was to devoting my life entirely to charity, and the other was to be in politics. And there was difficult decisions, because the first was my intent to establish a medical and dental college, and I was the first applicant in the 70s to be able to do that. And when the government, democratic government, came up in 1988, so the first permission they gave was to me to establish a medical and dental college. And I decided then that if I would do this, I'll have to devote my entire life to this cause. And I thought that politics was creating a bigger cleavage in society, so I gave that up. And later on, I gave up a few charitable causes just to concentrate on this. But on a personal level, we've been involved, my wife particularly, we've been involved in a number of charities, like TCF, for example, and every charity we come across, which we need to do. But then I look back. There is a Pakistan factor in my discussion today, and there's an international factor in my discussion. When I look at the Pakistan factor, what motivates the society to give towards charity? And of course, religion is a very major factor. And the first surah of Quran, which starts with Alif Lam Mim, Zalikal Kitabu La Raiba Fi, Hudalil Muttaqeen Al Lazina Yuminuna Bil Ghaibi Wa Yuqimuna Salata Wa Mimma Razaqnahum Yunfiqoon. Just closing it there, it goes beyond. That the Quran establishes the fact that this is a book which doesn't apply, but this is a book for those people who are muttaqis or Muslims. And how does it describe it? It describes it those who believe in God, for example. And then it says, those to whom Allah has given, and they do charity. So the first few paragraphs of the Quran describe what a Muslim should be like. So my ethos and the ethos of the Muslim starts from there. Now there is a compulsion again, which is between me and my God, is of zakat. And there's another compulsion which comes out for having the pain of society in my heart, which is khairat. See, so zakat is a compulsion of 2.5%, but khairat can go beyond. And I would like to narrate a few ahadith. Ahadith are quotations of the Prophet, or for those of you who may not know, are quotations of the Prophet and his what he did in his lifetime, the incidents which he talked about. And I would like to particularly talk about charity throughout Muslim history, because that is my ethos. I look at what was done by people. What God ordained, of course, it is a motivation, but at the same time, then I look at what people did in the time of the Prophet or in the time of the Khulafa. And there's a incident in the time of the Prophet when he said, is there anybody who would give loan to Allah? And Allah ko qarz do. And at the same time, there were two surahs in Quran which had come down and which talked about giving loans to Allah, qarz, Allah ko qarz do. And it will be returned with Prophet, it will be returned to you. So there was a Sahabi sitting there, and he said, does Allah need a loan? And the Prophet said, yes, because it comes back to you in multiplied in many times. So he said, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, may I hold your hand? And the Prophet said, yes. And he came forward and he held his hand. And he said to the Prophet that today, the all I own, which is a huge garden of dates, an orchard, and I would give it to Allah today. And he gave all his orchard, which had 600 trees at then, and then he came home. And he came home, and as he entered, his house was inside the orchard. And we came home, and he announced, and he shouted to his wife, that today I've given a loan to Allah, I've given everything to charity. And his wife responded from a distance, and she called the children, and she said, let's go. This has been given to Allah, and Allah will give us back whenever he feels that he should give back. So this is the ethos, this is the spirit with the Muslims here throughout that time. And the incidents of charity are full during the time of Medina and during the time of Caliphs. And the charity was done immediately, the same day. It was not left to a planning, because in those days, it was the most efficient thing was to disburse it in the same day. And there was one incident in the time of the Prophet when taxes came from Bahrain, and then in the time of Hazrat Umar when taxes came from Bahrain, 5 lakh dirhams came, and before the night was over, it was distributed to charity. Then some camels came, Hazrat Abu Bakr distributed them to charity, and he said that tomorrow, today these camels have come, tomorrow I'll go to every house in Medina, look for people who deserve that, and I would dispense them off the next day. So there has been a history of how people have done charity, you know. And there was an incident in one of the Khalifa's time that somebody heard that Muslims are also give the fundamentals of Islam include Hajj in a lifetime if somebody can afford it. And there was an incident in which somebody spread the message in Kaaba, the Hajj of one cobbler from such and such city in Syria has been accepted. And so some people went out to look for him, and they asked him, they found out that man, and they asked him, did you go for Hajj? And he said, no, I didn't go for Hajj.
سر ڈاکٹر عارف الوی اسلام آباد میں تقریب سے خطاب کر رہے ہیں ان کا یہ کہہ رہے ہیں کہ انسانیت اور پسماندہ طبقوں کی فلاح و بہبود مشترکہ مقصد ہے یہ تھی پی ٹی وی تازہ ترین ایک بریک کے بعد حاضر ہوں گے ہیڈ لائنز کے ساتھ